I'm Gil, circular business designer at Switchers. In this video, I'll explain the circular design map. The circular design map helps you to brainstorm on possible circular business models and to find new business opportunities. You can download this tool for free at diy.switchers.com. This tool gives you a quick overview of material flows and what you can do with them. The idea is that you map your product or a part of your product from the virgin materials up until the end of life phase. So we start from the raw or virgin materials, go over production to distribution to the use phase, and finally waste stream valorization, incineration and or dumping of the leftover materials. The goal is that you try to draw a line from the left side from your materials all the way to the right side, which is the end of life for your SS model, and then see in how you could make that flow of materials more circular. In the virgin material blocks on the left, you'll find both the energy and the materials used. Are you using renewable or non-renewable energy? Is your product made out of fossil-based materials like oil-based plastics? Reusable but non-renewable materials like iron, marble, or technical biomaterials are materials from a renewable feedstock like cornstarch, linseed oil, but which you can't directly put back into nature. And finally, the biomaterials, which are compostable bio-based materials. In this block, it's important to understand the difference between the biodegradable and the biocompostable materials. Our next step is production. Here we let some extra blanks in so you can make some nuances in the process that are done by you versus third-party providers. Next, we talk about the different channels you use to bring your product or service to your customer. Quite possibly you're using several channels depending on the target audience. Your own channels, online or offline, retailers or shops owned by others, or you sell a product service system. Here, you don't sell your product as such, but the functionality of your product. Next step, the use phase. Your product can be used in a B2B, B2C, or even a peer-to-peer context. Additionally, you or someone else can also offer repair services during the use phase. Once a product gets outdated, worn out, breaks down, it will find one way or the other to the waste pile. Is there some sort of recycling program, either owned by you or set up by your local government? How about waste collection schemes? A composting process at home of an industrial scale can be used when you're working with biodegradable or biocompostable materials. Try to think in a next cycle. If the materials are recycled, who is using them afterwards? Are you taking them back? Are they put back in the market? If you're composting, your process might help in growing new crops or generating new energy. If the materials are not reused, the leftovers move to the waste pile, where they either get incinerated or dumped. Even through incineration might give you some extra energy you can use for the production. From a material circular economy point of view, it's an end of the road kind of strategy, since the materials themselves are forever lost after that step. Now that we explained the different step in the circular design map, let's take a look how we use it. Let's try that with an example. Interface is a producer of carpet tiles for a B2B environment. First, we map out the simplified business as usual scenario of Interface with a red marker. Nylon and rubber are created from fossil materials, are then through production converted into carpet tiles, which are then sold to companies who want carpet tiles for their offices. And end of life, these carpets go to an incineration plant for energy recovery. Once we got the baseline measurements, we start to explore with a green marker. Are there other opportunities and alternatives? Trying to keep in mind the nature of the product, costs, user behavior, and habits. Interface figured they might actually do things a little bit different, but also better. Better for themselves, business-wise, but also better for the environment. So they started setting up these take-back schemes, where they would pick up an old, used carpet tiles, strip the rubber, which they could reuse pretty much immediately again, and recycle the nylon into new nylon. This switch also meant that instead of selling, it made more sense to lease or rent the tiles in a product service system, because then they could keep better track of where the tiles were. Once this model started rolling, interface started thinking about the front end of their model. At the end of the pipelines, things are pretty much closed, as you can see. But in a business model that grows, new oil-based plastics are still needed. That's when they came up with the idea of NetEffect. One of the iconic places where you can find nylon as a waste stream is in the oceans, in the form of discarded fishing nets. These nets are extremely damaging to the ecosystem for ocean, entangling and suffocating enormous amount of animals. Together with local fishing communities, they started to collect old and used fishing nets and recycle them into new nylon for the carpets. This way, they didn't only choose the loop at the end of the use phase, they also designed a business model that helps them cleaning up the oceans. This is how the circular design map can work for you. I hope you enjoyed this short introduction of the circular design map. We're really looking forward to seeing if and how you use these tools, so please share your work and show us what you'll be creating. Go to diy.switches.com and find more free innovation tools and brainstorm exercises.